jokes aside, it's just too soon. If anything, if I was him, I would probably wait 2 weeks and then decide whether or not I would open up the practice facilities, not say, okay, well, it's just showing signs of slowing down, let's open up the practice facility. But that's my larger problem with a lot of businesses around this time. They're trying to open up. They're like, okay, well, we got to make money. And I completely understand. Look, I'm trying to make money too. But at the same time, it's like, what level of risk are you willing to take? Are you comfortable with? And this is not the kind of risk like, oh, we're going to lose a couple of $1,000, a couple of $1,000,000. No, you're going to lose somebody's life. This is not the regular kind of risk that businesses are necessarily used to dealing with. And technically, they shouldn't have to ever deal with that. But unfortunately, this is the case. Of course, with business, there is always risk. And you have to be comfortable with a certain level of risk. And I completely understand that. Again, the problem is the risk is human lives. How many players are you willing to potentially lose to this disease for you to continue to make money off of the NBA? And that's not a question I can necessarily answer for Adam Silver. That is a question that he has to ask himself. And obviously, by what he's doing, he feels comfortable enough with potentially losing a couple lives. So we'll be paying attention to that. Continuing on, guys. Listen, the Jadeveon Clowney situation. If you guys haven't been paying attention, Jadeveon Clowney has been in a little bit of a standoff with the Seattle Seahawks. I'm not quite sure why he's even doing this. I guess he's assuming that, you know, he's proved his worth with 3 sacks last year, so pay him. Unfortunately, he is a great guy regarding his defense, but he's definitely not worth paying any more than he got paid last year. So he's kind of off on a little bit of a stalemate. We're not quite sure what he's doing there. So he was trying to bluff out the Seattle Seahawks into paying him more, or he's not going to sign his contract. He's not going to sign any contract. Of course, the Seattle Seahawks have called his bluff, and right now Clowney is technically out of a job. He has put together some type of a training mix video for other places, as well as the Seattle Seahawks, to show that he's healthy and he has recovered from his injury last year. Now, the biggest problem is, unfortunately, he's trying to pull a Cam Newton. You may be healthy now, but the question is, can you stay healthy? And I think that a lot of these players are not thinking about situations like that. Yes, you are healthy now. Yes, you're excellent now. Yes, you can do it now, but will you be able to do it later? How long will you potentially be sidelined? How long will I have to put you on the injured reserve and end up essentially paying for dead money and not having the caliber of personnel that I thought that I was going to have, but unfortunately you're injured, so I'm going to have to deal with second best. And that's something that, again, these players are not thinking about. And I understand, that you think that you're healthy and that you think that, you know, you're going to be able to stay healthy forever. But unfortunately, especially within the NFL, people get injured. And injuries, the older you get, they sideline you longer and longer. And Jadeveon is not no spring chicken, so he will definitely be out for a considerable amount of time if he gets injured again. So the question is, will he humble himself enough to realize that this is definitely an issue with him? It's a risk, but it's not a risk that they're unwilling to take. The Seattle has said that they're willing to take Jadeveon back on. It's not an issue for them. Their biggest issue is dealing with the uncertainty that he brings on and how much money that he wants. If he can somehow lower his price tag to something that is considerably a little bit more pro than con to deal with the risk of having him, then hey, they'll definitely probably sign him, because they said that, you know, they have an open door policy for him. So again, that being said, we'll be paying attention to that. We're going to be seeing how that works out for him. Other than that, guys, it's going to be a pretty short episode. I'm not going to lie to you guys. not too much has been going on. Of course, you guys should be paying attention. I believe NFL teams have just started dropping their schedules. I know somebody was supposed to drop their schedule at 2 p.m. For the Carolina Panthers. They're going to be dropping their schedule at 8 p.m. So we're going to be giving some live reactions on our Twitter. Make sure that you follow us on Twitter, and that is at IDK underscore cast. Again, at IDK underscore cast. Make sure you follow us on our Twitter so you can get those live reactions of the NFL schedule. Now, there is a little bit of rumor going around that the first 4 weeks is going to be NFC versus AFC. So we're going to see whether or not that actually happens. That should actually be pretty interesting. That's a little bit more than we're used to dealing with different conferences matching towards each other. It's typically like maybe like 1 to 2 weeks. So we're going to see what's going to happen with the schedules, what these schedules are looking like. Who's going to be having a hard time? I'm praying that the camp will find some place to go. But for the Panthers, I'm hoping that we can have a somewhat challenging but somewhat easy schedule. We have a lot of new people, so we want to give them a little bit of a taste of the NFL, but we don't want it to be too difficult for us, for it to be a hard way for us to potentially get to the playoffs. And we may even make the playoffs this year. I can't necessarily say for certain because, like I said, it's a lot of new people. So I can't necessarily say that. I wish I could, because that would definitely make my day. Unfortunately, we're just gonna have to wait and see that schedule. So until then, guys, stay safe, wash your hands, and make sure that you're taking care of yourself and your family. All right? I will check in with you guys next week on Thursday at 6. Make sure that you're telling all your friends about this podcast. And hey, don't forget about our PodFan page. You can go to PodFan/IDKcast. We'll have all of our episodes uploaded on there. And for $2.99 a month, you can listen to all of our episodes ad-free. Plus, we're going to be adding a microcast. So we're going to be adding a podcast onto the podcast. You're going to be able to hear my sincere thoughts in 2 minutes or less. Hey, I think it's a whole lot that you're getting. All right, you're getting your favorite podcast episodes ad-free, plus the microcast and behind the scenes photos and videos. Plus, I'm going to be interacting with all the members on our member page on that website. So it's a must check out. There's so many great things going on over there. By the way, guys, I want to throw a quick thank you. We are at 207 downloads. This is a long way from where we started just 5 months ago with this podcast, a little less than 5 months ago. And that's what makes it even more extraordinary. Just want to say a quick thank you. The chances of there being a potential giveaway, I'm thinking of doing a giveaway, potentially $20 or $30. We'll see. I will update you. So in order to know about the giveaway, it's probably going to be again on our Twitter page. So make sure that you really follow us on Twitter, because if you guys want to be involved in that giveaway, the only way to know about it again is probably going to be on Twitter, because hey, we only host a podcast one day a week. So because I'm on that Twitter page every day out of the week. In fact, I'm on it right now. So it behooves you so much to follow us on that Twitter page. So, and there are probably going to be member updates on that as well. So, again, follow our Twitter. Make sure that you go to our website. Because how are you going to find out about this stuff if y'all not following? If y'all not catching the highlights? Like, again, guys. All right, I can't wait to see you guys again next week at 6. So many great things going to be going on. So, I will see you guys again next week. Peace out.